the Sahaba and Mahfuz, and this is across the board, but the higher the rank, as well as another issue, ijtihad, khata ijtihadi. This issue, even if a Sahabi who is a mujtahid commits khata in the ijtihad, the hadith that states, إِذَا اجْتَهَدَ الْمُجْتَهِدُ فَأَصَابَ فَلَهُ أَجْرَانِ وَإِذَا أَخْطَأَ فَلَهُ أَجْرٌ. Go and check what Al-Imam Abdul Wahhab al-Sha'rani says. Even the khata is a correct position in Al-Islam.
Subhanallah.
Even the khata of the mujtahid, because the sharia is بين العظيمة والرخصة. بين العظيمة والرخصة. So Al-Imam Abu Hanifa is correct. He will get two rewards. If he is wrong, he'll get one reward. But he is wrong doesn't mean it's not Sharia. So, if someone says a Sahabi or a Sahabiya made khata ijtihadi, it does not entail that they will do something that is ghair shari'i. It is essential. And with regard to Fadak, Sayyidatuna Fatima radiallahu anha, my position is that she did not make ijtihad in the first place. This is my position. She was mahfuzah. Sayyiduna Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu is mahfuz. And this nonsense that people have started, they should desist, and it's causing fitna amongst the public.